Hello my dear students, in the last class we discussed about how the main acquired immune system which is affect the vaccine and vaccination and the types of the immunity, right? Active immunity, passive immunity, right? And also it is a huge concept to know about and what are that immune response organs, okay, and where it is located, right? And in that, the immune system in our body, where it is located and what are the main immune system organs are located in our body. In that, mainly we are consider the immune system of our body, they are nothing but the lymphoid tissues and lymphoid nodes and its lymphoid cells and antibody. Okay, and these are we consider as B cells, T cells, these overall we called as the lymphoid organs, right? And in that, based on these all, where it is located and how it will be programming, due to that they are classified into primary lymphoid organs and secondary lymphoid organs. Okay, in that, the first primary, these are the major, okay, and these are very important for our immune system response. In that, there are four types, majority there are four types. Okay, in that first one, the bone marrow and thymus. In that, the bone marrow, mainly these primary lymphocytes are mainly which produces main lymphocytes. What are those lymphocytes? Are nothing but B cells and T cells. These are the main components which are helps for production of antibody antigens, right, and antigen killing agents, right? T cell mediated, we are studying, no, like that. These are the main important. And in that, where it's produced? In bone marrow. In that, firstly bone marrow, these all include blood cells, okay, and also produces lymphocyte cells are nothing but B cells and T cells. Okay, their lymphoid cells are nothing but B cells and T cells. Okay, in that second organ is thymus. This thymus is bilow and located near to the heart, exactly here. Okay, beneath the bone. Okay, breastbone beneath the area present here. Okay, and next, and B lymphocytes are nothing but B cells. Okay, and the B cells are produced in bone marrow and also matures in bone marrow. That's why it is called as B for bone marrow. Okay, and what is the T cells? And these T cells produced in bone marrow but matures in T thymus cell. That's why it is T for thymus. Understood? Based on their maturity, they are named as B cells and T cells. Okay, these are the main important we know about that. How the B cells affect the antigens and T cells affect the antigens in antibody mediated immune system and cell mediated immune system. Okay, in second lymphoid organ, secondary lymphoid organs are spleen, lymphoid cells, mucus associated lymphoid tissues, and next pairs, patches, and next tonsils. Okay, and appendix. These all are present in a small intestinal region and also helps for proliferation and differentiation. Proliferation means they are helps to involving or they helps to differentiation of varieties of lymphatic response or immune responses. Okay, next, in that first one point we study, first one is the spleen. The spleen is present in a bean shape. Mainly this bean shaped and contains the lymphocytes. Their lymphocytes are nothing but majority blood. RBC cells are mainly consist and phagocytes. We know about the phagocytes, I already discussed now. And these are the cell when antigen which will affect the cell. These are engulf these cells and destroy inside the, and they are, it is a solid dead. Why it is? Eating of cell. That's why it is phagocyte cells. Okay. And mainly it is a filter the blood. RBC filter in a spleen. And it is a very smallest gland. Okay. And also which trap the bone marrow of microbes. If blood consists any microbes, it trap that microbes and kill in the spleen only. And also it is called as large reservoir of RBC or erythrocytes, or also blood bank in our body is nothing but spleen, which store the RBC or erythrocytes. And next one is a lymphocytes. Lymph nodes are nothing but these are the small solid structure which is located at a different. If it is a body, some lymphatic. If we have a lymphatic nerves, in that some node which is present like this here, nodal region, and that node, in that node only the lymph nodes are present. Okay, and trap the microbes. And what is the main function? It trap the antigen. After it will go for lymph nodes, and after lymph nodes it activate and differentiation the lymphocytic cells. After that the immune system will be activated. Understood? First the antigen trapped by lymphoid cells or lymph nodes. After it will go for activation and differentiation of lymph cell. Differentiation in the cells, they are cell mediated or antibody mediated. And next it will cause immune system. Okay. And last not the least, that is mucosal associated lymphoid tissue. This is MALT. Important define or state or abbreviation of MALT. It is a very important question. Okay, next. And lining of a major tract. It is a outer lining, here lining of mucus, respiratory, nasal tract or the next digestive tract, and last urinal genital, in the sense the urine system and genital portion which is present. And also they consist 50% of lymphoid tissues. It consists 50% of lymphoid tissue, and these tissue which are has for secretion of mucus. Due to that mucus they consist acidic content, and due to that they are easy to kill the microbes. Understood? Okay, this is all about immune system in our body. How it will be and what type of immune system we have, and what are the cells, tissues and organs, and how it will be runs. Okay, where it is located. This is the most important for your NEET and CET purpose. So please remember which one is, how their function and where it is located. Okay, this is all about the immune system of in our body. Okay, if you have any doubts please comment. Okay, next for your syllabus they are given the main two major diseases. Okay, they are AIDS and cancer. Okay, for that your for your examination, these AIDS and cancers are very important for your examination. So please carefully listen and read. Okay, first the AIDS. The AIDS is nothing but, the abbreviation of AIDS is acquired immunodeficiency syndrome. Means they have a inviting the syndromes. They have a deficiency. Means the immune system is defected by this syndrome. Okay, when our immune system get collapsed, the syndromes get acquired. The syndromes get acquired. And these diseases, AIDS, which affect our immune system. Okay, and these AIDS is firstly reported at 1981, and this is a huge hazardous disease we are considered. Okay, this have no curance medicines, we know about that, but we have some precautions we will be studying. But what are the, how it AIDS will be caused by one virus. That virus is nothing but HIV, human immunovirus. Okay, and it is the structure of these retrovirus. And these retrovirus mainly consist three material: envelope, genetic material and capsid. Okay, these envelope is mainly made up of protein. Okay, and these genetic material which is because consider as RNA, ribonucleic acid. Okay, and these ribonucleic acid which is covered by a capsid. And this virus have a one special character or special enzyme that is nothing but reverse transcriptase. Transcriptase. And what is this reverse transcriptase? This is nothing but this virus have a capacity to convert RNA into DNA. This one we call as reverse transcriptase. Transcription means what? A DNA helps to synthesis RNA. But here the reverse transcription which is have a ulta means the RNA have the capacity to produce viral DNA, and due to this DNA when it will be secreted in our body, our lymphatic cells which are failed to recognize because they have a DNA. Due to that DNA, they have to understood that this is a self cell. Okay, due to that only it is can't be recognized. And these virus firstly infected the T helper cells. Okay, due to that T helper cells maintain the information given by these T helper cells, and they attack firstly these cells. Due to this, it will be collapse the stimulated our immune system. Okay, they are collapse our immune system. Due to that only we have a plenty of disease can be affected to our body due to the AIDS. That's why acquired immunodeficiency syndromes. Understood? Okay. What are the transmission? How mode of transmission? How it can be transmitted? This is also very important. How it will be transferred? How it will be recorded? First one. Okay, which is transmitted by contact with mode of transmission. First one, mode of transmission. Okay, first one, contact with infected person. First one. Second one, transpose of infected blood. Next one, using of infected needles. Okay, also comes from infected mother to child or fetus. Okay, and these are the main, and also by taking alcohol and drugs. By using these alcohol and drugs, they can easily infected by needles or some infected person. Okay, by using this one, these are the main four which are main. And also organ transplantation, also infected by, this is also main important, organ transplantation of infected person to normal or healthy person. Okay, see, these are the mode of transmission. How contact with the infected person. Infected person means contact, means when they are contact with, sex contact with infected person, and transposition of और ट्रांसप्लांटेशन ऑफ ब्लड और इन्फेक्टेड ब्लड टू नॉर्मल हेल्दी मैन. ओके, नेक्स्ट यूजिंग ऑफ इन्फेक्टेड नीडल्स राइट एंड इन्फेक्टेड मदर्स टू चाइल्ड और फीटस. एंड नेक्स्ट द ऑर्गन ट्रांसप्लांटेशन ऑफ इन्फेक्टेड पर्सन टू हेल्दी पर्सन और नॉर्मल पर्सन. दीज आर द मोड ऑफ ट्रांसमिशन हाउ द HIV can be transferred or HIV can be infected. And before, after that, the life cycle of HIV. How it will be infect and what are the changes occur in our cell and after how it will be infected to other cells. See here. Firstly, this one is a normal our cell and this consists cytoplasm and it consists the nucleus. Okay. This is our normal cell. When our retrovirus which is infected to here the T helper cells are present. They affect firstly T helper cells. After that they are introduced into a cell. And after that only the RNA can porated or enter into a cell. After that help of reverse transcriptase it is converted into viral DNA. Viral RNA to viral DNA. After that it is go for DNA and it is changes our DNA and they help, they are replicated as a DNAs. After they will be produce this new viral RNA due to by using this DNA only they form RNA because the DNA is the main function of DNA is nothing but DNA which is produces the RNA. Right, and these DNA is infected by these viral DNA, and due to that, these infected viral DNA only produces the RNA that is nothing but the new viruses, and these new viruses structure the cell and infect the other cell. Like that only it will be transferred. This is a main important question for your exam. Explain the life cycle of HIV or explain how RNA will works in our normal cell. Okay, this is very important. Firstly, the RNA of virus infected to cell and the viral RNA enter into the cell and after that by using reverse transcriptase, it affects the T cells, after it will become your DNA and after the viral DNA which produces viral RNAs and they form new viruses and produces new cell and due to these cell which infected to other cells. This is a main life cycle of HIV. Okay, and what are the precautions? See here, due to the reaction of or collapse of T helper cells and our whole immune system get reduced or decreases. Due to this condition, the infection of other syndromes or other diseases will be more because the responding immune system is collapsed. Okay, due to that collapsing, the main purpose which if we have to infected by TB also, malaria also, cholera also, and if we have common cold, then that common cold also not curable by our immune system. That type of collapsation of immune system takes place by this virus. Okay, due to that toxoplasma, this type of diseases will be acquired to our body and due to that only the person can be leads to a death. Okay, and next how it can be they have no treatments of AIDS, but we can diagnose or we can identify or we can diagnose by the test that is ELISA. That test is ELISA. Due to that ELISA, what is ELISA? Enzyme linked immune sortable psi. And due to by this test we can test HIV positive or negative. Very important ELISA test. Due to that ELISA test only we can diagnose the HIV. Okay. And next, the HIV which have no medicines, we know about that. But before the disease, we can get some precautions. Due to that precaution, we can prevent the disease to infect. Okay, what are that precautions? That precautions are nothing but first one, the safe sex, first one. Okay, or distribution of free condoms and use a new needle. Okay, and by the vaccination we can prevent fetus to mother. Okay. Next. Okay, first one, that is a safe blood transfusions. Second, the safe blood transfusions and also the safe organ transplantation. Okay, see here. Safe sex means by using some barriers we can contact. Two, if unknown person we can by unknown person to avoid our sex, avoid with unknown person. Okay, and second one, distribution of free condoms, and next using the new needles for particular persons, and next prevent the fetus by diagnose the mother to fetus, we can prevent, and save blood transfusion and save organ transplantation. This is all about the AIDS disease, which is a hazardous disease, which is not curable disease. We can, before we are going to infect, it will be get precautions are very good for infection. Okay, precautions are very helpful to avoid the infections. Okay, and these are the main information about AIDS, and this is very important for your examination. So please keep reading and have to remember these all things. Okay, and if you have any doubts, please comment. Okay, thank you.